In this video, I'm gonna show you how to play God of War 3 and Ascension on PC with the best settings. Both games are very demanding on the emulator, especially on the CPU. But with these settings, I was getting 45 to 60 FPS on God of War 3, even on sections where there's a lot going on. But on Ascension, the performance was worse, averaging from 30 FPS and high, but stable overall. These settings will also minimize the potential crashes that could happen so you can get the best experience. This is a new version of my original tutorial video with a few improvements, so without wasting any time, let's get started. We'll begin by downloading RPCS3, the PS3 emulator. I'll put the link down below, and here on the main page, you just have to click here on the download button, and then you download the emulator for the operational system you're using. In my case, I'm using Windows, so I'm gonna click on this one and then place it on the folder of your preference on your PC. It will come as a zipped file, so you have to extract it with either WinRAR or 7-zip. In my case, I'm using 7-zip, so I'm just gonna extract the file here. And you can go ahead and delete the original one. We're not gonna need that anymore. And to begin, you just have to double click here on rpcs3.ex to start the installation. And here there's a few options if you want to create a desktop shortcut and stuff. I would not recommend using the dark theme yet, so I'm gonna turn this off. And then just click here on Do Not Show Again, and I have read the quick start guide, and then just select here on Continue. And there you go, we have RPCS3 on our computer. First, we have to install the PS3 firmware on the emulator, and we can get that on the official Sony website. This is the place right here. The link will be down below. And on this page, you want to scroll down here to the bottom a little bit, and where it says how to update PS3 system software, you want to click here on update using a computer. And then you just click on download PS3 update and place the file on the same emulator folder. If for some reason the download doesn't start when you click on it, then you have to click on it with the right button on your mouse and then select copy link address, and then paste the link on your browser and press enter. Then the download will start. Now back on the emulator folder, I already downloaded my firmware here. It is this file, the PS3 update. Now you wanna go to the emulator and right here, click on file and click on install firmware. It should open the emulator folder by default. So now you just have to double click here on the PS3 update, and it will install the firmware on RPCS3. Click here and Do Not Show Again, and then click OK. And now it will install these PPU modules, but this shouldn't take long. And while you wait for it to finish, this will be a good time to subscribe to the channel and also leave a like on this video. I would really appreciate it. As for getting the games, you can either dump your copies to your PC or get them from the internet. And I can't show you here on the video or even mention it how to do it, because this is against YouTube's policy. And when you get the games, you can place them right here on this games folder on the emulator folder like this. This will be the default folder that the emulator is going to scan for the games. If you had your emulator open while doing all of this, go ahead and close it down, reopen, and the games should appear right here. If they don't show up for whatever reason, click here on file and then click on add games, and then just select the games folder here again. Very simple, right? Now, these are the vanilla versions of the game. We don't have the patches yet. And we can get them using a little tool that is very simple to use. Using this tool right here, Rusty PSN. The link will be down below as well. So here on this page, you just wanna click here on the latest release available. It is version 3.7. And then just scroll down here to the bottom, and you have to download this file right here, the rustypsn.ege.windows.zip. Download this file if you are using Windows like I am. You can place it on the same emulator folder. Now back on the RPCS3 folder, the file is right here, the rustypsn that is, so you just have to extract the single .ex file that is inside of it with either WinRAR or 7-zip here. And then now you just have to double click here on the rustypsn.ex and the tool will open. Before you start downloading the patches, I want you to click here on this little gear so you can change the download location for the patches. In my case, I like to create a new folder on the emulator folder here called updates, just so that I can keep things organized, you know? And now go back to rustypsn and then select pick folder, and then select that one updates folder that we just created. Remember, this is optional. This is up to you how you want to download this, but I like doing it like this. So now click here on save settings. With Rusty PSN already configured, to download the updates, we're gonna need the game serial code, and we can get them on the emulator right here. So I'm gonna start with God of War 3. Right here on the game, click on it with the right button. Then the option from the bottom, copy info, click here on copy serial. Now go back to Rusty PSN and copy the serial right here. And click on search for updates, and it's going to list all the updates available for the game. There's only one update for God of War 3, so that's all we're gonna need. So just click here on download file. This one shouldn't take long, and there you go, it's ready. Now we're gonna do the same thing for God of War Ascension. Click on the game with the right button, the option from the bottom, copy info, copy serial. Go back to Rusty PSN, delete the code from God of War 3, paste this one. Search for updates. Now, God of War Ascension has several updates, but the only one we're gonna need is 1.04. Do not update this game beyond this version, because it's mostly content for the game multiplayer mode. And if you update the game with everything, it can cause a freeze on the emulator. So 1.04 is the only one we're gonna need. So click on download file, wait until it is finished, and there you go, it's ready. You can now close Rusty PSN. Now here back on the emulator, click here on file, and then click on install packages RPCS3. Now go to the emulator folder and select that updates folder we created before. This one right here. It's going to list the updates for God of War 3 and Ascension. This one is God of War 3, so let's start with this one. Simply just select this one, click on open. It's going to ask if you want to install. Click on yes, and there you go. God of War 3 is updated. Now do the same thing for God of War Ascension. Install packages, updates. There you go. And open. Yes, install. And there you go. Both games are updated, but Ascension only up to 1.04. That's what we're gonna need. Now we're going to enable the community patches for both of these games, and they're required for getting more performance out of them. Let's start with God of War 3. So click on it with the right button and select this option here, manage game patches. Here we're going to select the patches from version 1.03, which is what we have here. And basically the options you want to have enabled here are disable color grading, disable layered fog. These two will make the game look a little worse, but it's going to give you 10 to 15 FPS increase on gameplay, so it's absolutely worth it. Also disable MLAA, disable motion blur if you feel like it, and disable SPU MLAA. You can also enable to skip any buttons with X and intro, and also unlock FPS as well, so we can get 60. And there you go. So hit apply and then save. And now we're gonna do the same thing for God of War Ascension. Click on it with the right button, manage game patches, and we're going to select from 1.04 right here. Basically, the only option for performance is disable MLAA, but you can once again disable motion blur, skip the intro, and unlock FPS. Click on apply and then save. Now we're going to configure the emulator settings for both of these games, and this is probably the most important part of this tutorial for getting the best performance out of these games right now. So starting with God of War 3, click again with the right button and select here, create custom configuration from global settings. This window will show up, and on the CPU tab, the first option is SPU X Float Accuracy. Change this one to relaxed, and the SPU block size, change this one to mega. Now click on the GPU tab, and right here, make sure that the renderer is set to Vulkan. If it's not available for you, you can leave it as OpenGL, but preferably set this to Vulkan. Here on the frame limit, set this to 60. Otherwise, if at some point in the game, the FPS goes any higher than that, it will speed up the rest of the game. Keep the default resolution at recommended, but if you plan on upscaling the resolution, you're gonna use this slide right here. But if you do so, if you upscale the resolution to anything higher than 720p, you have to change the scale threshold right here to 160 by 160. You can use the keys on the keyboard. Keep it precise like this. Otherwise, if you're going to play this at 720p, keep this one at the default as well. Now on additional settings, enable right color buffers and texture streaming. Now click on the Advanced tab and change the RSX FIFO accuracy to Atomic and the driver wake up delay. At first, you're gonna change this one to 50. This option is required from preventing the crashes from happening at the game. But even after you set this to 50, if the game is still crashing, you can go back here and set this to 100. If the game's still crashing, you can increase by 50 again and keep it on 150 and so on. But in my case, when I set mine to 50, I didn't have any crashes or anything like that. But if it does happen, you already know what to do. Now we have to configure God of War Ascension. So click on it with the right button and same option, create custom configuration. On the CPU tab, the only option you have to change is SPU block size. Change this to mega. Now click on the GPU tab. Make sure that the render is set to Vulkan if it's available. Set the frame limit to 60. And on this option, Z-Cure accuracy, change this to relaxed fastest. And on additional settings, enable right color buffers. Now click on Advanced tab. And here on the core, enable accurate RSX reservation access. Here on the bottom where it says sleep timers accuracy, change this one to as host. Finally, the RSX FIFO accuracy, change this one to Atomic. That's pretty much it. Now click on Apply and then Save Custom Configuration. And lastly, we have to configure the controller. So click here on Pads, and if you already have your controller plugged in, it's going to show up right here which one you're using. If you don't have it, go ahead and plug it in. In my case, I'm using a Xbox controller, so I just have to click here on X input, and it's already going to do the auto mapping for me for all the buttons. And there you go, you can start playing the games. So I'm gonna start with God of War 3. So just double click the game. I'm going to ask if you want to install the digital manual. That's not necessary, right? That's optional, up to you. And when you boot this for the first time, it's going to build this SPU cache and also some modules as well. So just wait until it is finished and you can start playing. I have many videos like this on the channel covering how to install and play games on PC with the best settings for performance and graphics. So if you like what you saw, don't forget to subscribe, hit the like button, and as always, I'll see you soon.